Hello, this is Pastor Sandra Kennedy here at Whole Life Ministries in Augusta, Georgia. I guess you just think that we just have exciting things all the time. If you don't think that, then you're thinking wrong. We do have exciting things happening all the time, and you're going to love this message. It has to do with breakthrough, and it's a healing explosion that took place just right here at Whole Life Ministries not too long ago. It was wonderful. We were talking about people getting stuck. You just get stuck. You seem like you can't get past that. And so we taught on how to break out of that little hole you get in. Get out of it and let God just be God in your life so that you can take hold of what God has already done for you. Remember, we're not trying to get God to do something. We're trying to believe He's done it and then grabbing it as He offers it to us. I believe you'll be so blessed. So many people got blessed that night. And that's another night where the Spirit of the Lord, I don't know if they could short all on this one thing, but it was absolutely fabulous how God invaded the place that night. You know, of all faith is, I'm operating in faith tonight. Every time I come to do a meeting, I'm operating in faith. Amen. Because I'm not a healer. And yet I can tell you that you're going to be healed. Amen. I walk in here and boldly say, I know that I know that I know that healings will take place in here tonight. Amen. And to say that it can happen to anybody and everybody who wants it. But you just have to believe. So all that you have to do is convince yourself that God didn't lie about it. So simple. I could say this and say, goodbye, let's go home. All you have to do is decide that God did not lie, that healing belongs to you, and you'll be in it for the long haul until it shows itself based on what God said. And you won't let what you see or feel make God a liar. And when you don't have the strength to do it, you need somebody around you who will do it for you. You need somebody around you who will say it for you. Now, more than likely, you'll get mad if they keep telling you, well, I'm sorry, but the Word says, the Word says, the Word says. The deal is you can't come off the Word. You can never come off the Word. You can never come off the Word. You can never let anything be more powerful than the Word of God. You let nothing be more powerful than the Word of God. Absolutely nothing be more powerful than the Word of God. That God's Word works in any and every situation. It's working for you now. And so the ground that you and I stand on, believing that we're going to heaven, is we just believe the Word of God. Amen. We accept it. Matter of fact, the Amazing Grace, the song that we sang, the Amazing Grace has a, I think it's in the, I can't remember the verses of it. It's maybe in the second verse. No. It's amazing. Sing it for me.
Precious is the grace appeared the hour I first believed.
Did you hear it? Did you get it? Yes. Say it again. Say that.
How precious is the grace appeared the hour I first believed.
Grace did not appear until you believed. Grace did not appear until you believed. And yet grace has always been here. Grace has always been here, but it didn't appear until you believed. That's the whole essence of receiving from God. You believe it, then you get it. And you don't get it before you believe it. But you got to believe it first. When you believe it, you receive what God gave to you years ago. Hallelujah. But you have to believe it in order to get it. Yes. It appeared when I believed, but it was there the whole time. But it didn't show up for me. Hallelujah. It didn't show up for me. It was there, but it didn't show up for me until I believed. Amen. And when I believed, grace appeared. Yes. No. It just appeared for me. Yes. It didn't appear. It appeared for me. It appeared for me when I believed. That's identical with healing. Healing appeared when I believed. When you make it yours, you don't let anybody take it from you. You make it yours, you claim it, refuse to move off of it. It will appear. It will show itself at that moment. Not when I believe. When I believe, it appears for me. Right. When you believe, it appears for you. Yet it's already in here. Yes. Healing's all over the place. You know where healing is? It's inside of you. Amen. Every single person has the healing power of God already in them. Yes. We've got to get it out. Yes. We've got to get it out. Praise the name of the Lord. Thank you. Thank you. You've got to remember that the man on the inside, the inner man, the man on the inside, the man on the inside is not moved by the five senses. Now, let me tell you who the man on the inside is, because some of you don't know who that is. You mean you got somebody in you? Yeah. It's called you. You live inside of the body. You live inside of the body. I have to teach this every single where I go. You live inside of the body. You are not the body. You are not your body. You are not shutting down. You don't have cancer. You don't have a kidney problem. You don't have these problems. Your body has them. But you're not the body. Man is three parts, spirit, soul, and body. You are a spirit. You are a spirit made in the image of God. But when you got born again, then God moved inside of you. Inside of your spirit man. Inside of your spirit man. I can teach this 1,000 times and I never teach it that somebody doesn't see it for the first time. No matter how many times they've heard it. If you ever really get it, you've got it. If you ever really get it. You are not here tonight because you have a problem. Now, if you're not born again, you're here because you got a problem. If you're not born again, you got a problem. You're on your way to hell. You got a problem. You don't belong to God. You got a problem. But if you're born again, you don't have a problem. The body has a problem. And the body has a problem basically because the soul, the thinking processes has agreed with the body. Instead of agreeing with God inside of you.
All right.
Amen. Are you with me?
Yes.
If when I look out at you, I see bodies. Okay. I see bodies. But you're not that body. Amen. That's just your house.
Yep.
Once you realize that the house is not supposed to rule the person who lives in it. In the natural. The house is not supposed to be in charge of the person who lives on the inside. You're supposed to be in charge of the house. So here we are. I am a spirit. I'm born again. So I'm made in the image of God. God Himself, in the name of the Holy Spirit, moved inside of me. God lives in me. God lives in me. Anybody who's born again, God lives in you.
Thank you, Lord.
Now, who did all of the healing in the New Testament? The Holy Spirit. Through Jesus. Jesus working through, the Holy Spirit working through Jesus. Jesus did not one miracle before the Holy Spirit came upon him on the River Jordan. If you're looking around at your neighbor and saying, where'd this woman come from? Out of the Bible. So if you're looking around, it just means you don't know the Bible. That's all it means. Hallelujah. I never heard that. It just means you don't know your Bible. So, you know, act like you know it. So hallelujah. All right. So when you get born again, the Holy Spirit moves inside of you. So the healing power of God is already inside of any person who's born again. Now, that's shouting ground. Because that means we don't have to go out hunting the Holy Spirit. We don't have to go out hunting the healer. The healer's inside of you. Well, the healer has to get to your body. But there's a layer in here outside of it being fat. There's a layer in here that is your thinking processes.
Yes.
Call it your soulish area.
Right.
And your soul is the way you think.
Yes.
And if you don't think the way God thinks, then you can only think two ways. The way of the world or the way of God. The way of the world is going to go with the flesh. And the way of the world is going to be moved by your five senses.
Yes.
And depending on what you think is whether or not the healing power of God can get outside to your body. It's up to you. That's not up to God.
Amen.
The question really is we got to get past the looking and the feeling.
Amen.
We got to get past looking and feeling, and we got to get to the Word. That's why it is imperative that you hear the Word of God over and over and over and over and over. Because you are correcting your soulish area. Let me put it this way. You're correcting your feeling and seeing area. The Bible says in Proverbs, the Bible says, in case those of you who are concerned and don't want to take medicine, I know that a lot of people don't believe in taking medicine. Well, you got a problem because the Bible calls the Bible medicine.
Amen.
That's the terminology it uses. That's the term it uses in Proverbs. Proverbs 4. Let's go over there. Proverbs 4. It literally calls it medicine. My son, attend to my words. Proverbs 4, hallelujah, 20. My son, attend to my words. My daughter, do it too. Incline thine ear unto my sayings. Now, this is saying, if you give your attention to the word and get off all this mess, your whole life has been built on mess. So if you get off the mess, attend to the word, attend to it.
Yes.
If you're going to have to attend to something, it's a daily process.
Yes, it is.
Amen.
If you are attending to your body functions, it's a daily process.
Yes.
I thought I'd make it so we'd all understand.
Yes.
Everybody understand that?
Yes.
You don't just attend to that one time a day.
Amen.
Hallelujah. If you do, you got a problem. We need to pray. But anyway, here we go. My son, attend to my word. So I've got to attend to this body.
Yes.
Then I've got to attend to the word of God.
Yes.
To put the word of God, make it bigger than my body.
Yes.
So here we go. My son, attend to my words. Incline thine ear to my sayings. How can you incline your ear to his sayings if you don't hear him saying it? How can you incline your ear to what God is saying? Now, what is he talking about? Don't incline your ear to Armageddon, not if you need healing. You have to pay attention to what God's word. So what do you want to do? Go to the Bible on healing.
Amen.
Get you a good healing scripture promise book. You are not waiting on healing. You're waiting on your body to catch up with your mind. And your mind has got to be hooked up with your spirit, so you're waiting on your body to hook up with your spirit. So the power can flow from the spirit man through your stinking thinking all the way to your body. Do you understand? It comes that process because the body out here is moved by everything, all five senses. Everything moves it. And if you are a person who is prone to absolutely let everything out here regulate everything about you, then we're going to have to really work on you.
Amen.
Because the devil knows that more than I know that. The devil knows. Oh, they're easy. But you got to believe it. You got to believe it. And you have to believe it beyond. And listen, you're going to get, your mouth will regulate where your brain goes, and it regulates where your body ends up.
Yes. Yes, 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 yes.
The confession of your mouth,
yes,
will rule your life.
Yes, it will.
So let's go back. Here we are. Let them, the word of God, not depart from your eyes. Well, The only way I know I can keep from being in front of my eyes is I got to be looking at it some way.
Amen.
You got to get the word out in front of you. And you don't try to read Genesis to Revelation. Find you one good scripture that just goes off inside of you on healing.
Right.
Again, on healing.
Right.
On healing. He sent his word and healed me. By stripes I am healed. I love old things that passed away. Behold, all things are new.
Amen. And,
you know, that God has already made a provision for everything in me to be new and to start over again.
Yes.
Now here it goes. What does he say? Let them not depart from my eyes. Keep them in the midst of my heart. Keep the word of God so that instead of me thinking all this area, that I'm thinking about what God said.
Yes.
This is what God said. I absolutely promise you. I mean, I just promise you, if you'll get the word of God and keep the word of God pumping in and in front of you so that before you know it, you are absolutely repeating it with him. You're quoting it back. It's your first response. You will begin to see progress.
Amen.
I guarantee you. Now, and then it says, for they, the word, are life unto those that find them. So that's something that you have to find. You have to make it yours.
Yes.
It has to become, it's sort of like grace, what we said. Grace was here, but it wasn't there until you got it.
Right.
Healing is here. Healing is in your body right now.
Hallelujah.
You've got to find it. How do you find it? By getting all the other mess out of the way.
Yes.
And by believing what God says more than the report.
Yes.
And here we go. That's why we have to say, whose, you know, report are you going to believe? You believe God's report? Or you believe this report? Both of them can be true. Both reports can be true. But one can have more power than the other.
Amen.
And the one that has the power is where you put your faith.
Yes.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
All right. So then it says, for they are life unto those that find them, and health are medicine to all your flesh. Notice that the word of God is medicine to your flesh.
Amen.
You know that right? That scripture right by itself should be sufficient.
Amen.
It's medicine to your body. The word of God, what God says about healing. You cannot find where it says if it's God's will, he will heal you.
Amen.
That does not exist in the Bible. So I have got to take the word of God and realize when I find me a scripture, there are tons of them, when I find me a scripture that ministers to me,
yes,
about healing, and I grab hold of it and I repeat it, and then I take that as a medicine, as a pill, every day.
Amen.
Not just as needed.
Yes.
You do that once you got it.
Right.
When the devil tries to raise his head. But in the meantime, you have to take it at least 3 times a day. Matter of fact, you might have to take it 5 and 6 times a day.
Yes.
And you take it and you, hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus, that you're not a man that you should lie. It's working powerfully, pushing out. Sickness and disease out of my body, getting it out of me in the name of Jesus. I will live and not die. You have to start with that one. You have to start with that. Where do I start? Right there.
Amen.
I will live and not die and declare the works of the Lord.
Amen.
So you got the first thing you have to do is decide you're going to live. You know what we need to do? We need to get the light to come on. Because when the light comes on, the darkness will go.
Yes, it will.
So you need to get the light on in your head. You know, you need to somewhere get in there. God is not mad with me. God is on my side. God's in the healing business. God wants nothing but good from me. Every good gift comes from God. God is not out. I can't help it if this runs in your family. Run it out of your family. You can stand up in the name of Jesus and make it bow to the name of Jesus. And you have to, I would rather die going down whispering the word of God on my lips than to die wondering what's happening.
Amen. Amen.
I'd rather meet God saying, by your stripes, I'm healed. No matter what, than saying, you let me down. He'll never let you down. Amen. He will never let you down. Amen. You've got to believe what God said he has done. You've got to believe it. You know, when you come to the things of God, and particularly what I've said tonight, is so simple. This, I can't get any simpler than that. I have to do the same thing you have to do. I have to confess. I have to say. I have to believe. I have to call somebody to pray and believe with me. Hallelujah. And you make sure you got four crazy friends. Four crazy friends are the friends who took the guy up on top of the roof and took the roof off and let him down in front of Jesus.
Yes.
You got to make sure you got people who really believe and are standing with you. And then you don't go around questioning where God's really in the healing business or this, that, and the other. No, what you have to decide is, where are you? Where are you about faith? Where are you about living? Do you want to really live? You got to decide that first. Do you want to live? Do you want to live? If I could help everybody know that God has a particular plan for you, my goodness, how different it would be if you'd fight to finish your race. Fight to finish your race. Don't let the body take you out. Because you can't be here without it. So you've got to have control over that body. You got to talk to it. You say, I do, it just doesn't listen. You got to keep talking to it. And 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 don't do yourself in by feeling guilty and say, I guess I just don't have any faith. No, it means that you're having a struggle and need somebody to stand with you.
Yes.
And there's nothing wrong with asking somebody to stand with you. Somebody to stand with you. Somebody to stand with you. How many of you have, this certainly has been different tonight. How many of you have been believing God for a long time for something and have not seen anything happen? I want you to stand up. I mean, you've been living for a long time, been believing, and you just have not seen it happen. Now, I tell you what the rest of us are going to do. The rest of us are going to be her and Aaron. So all you hers, we are going to undergird you. Those who are around, look at people standing where you are. Now, if you who are standing, don't look around. People who are seated, you say, but I'm sick too. And it's no better way in the world to get healed than to pray for somebody else. Amen. If you're having trouble standing, just sit. Just put your hand up. If you're having trouble standing, sit. Now, everybody who's seen that person stand, they're saying that they're standing. They believe in God, but they haven't seen. We're going to say it's the first of the year we need a breakthrough.
Amen.
Okay? We're going to have a breakthrough. This is a turnaround moment. This is, we're holding your hands up. We say that you're going to live and not die. We say that your body is going to respond to the word of the Lord. We say we undergird you. In the name of Jesus. And we say, well, you put your faith out there that we speak to the demonic forces in the name of Jesus that's held you back in Jesus' name. And we break their power in the name of Jesus. We lift up the word of the Lord. And we say that by the stripes of Jesus, you are healed. Say it, come on. By the stripes of Jesus, you are healed. Say it to him again. By the stripes of Jesus, you are healed. Tell him again. By the stripes of Jesus, you are healed. Tell him another time.
By the stripes of Jesus,
you are healed.